If you don't look at Koro, you hear me whine. I say you tanda gidigba on top of the chairman television station, Wazobia Max TV. And this, na Coco of the matter. Every Wednesday, the Coco went inside the matter. Now we the carry come. We go drop her. Carry person will sabi where. To chook mouth on top. The idea now so that all of us when they watch for house, we go learn, no? And I know say, when you learn, you go fit do the right things. When you do the right things, bad things, no go continue to the cause problem inside with society. The Ogbonge visitor, when carry, Waka come join me for studio today. Now, person will be say, if they passionate about Obodo Nigeria, now he make up, go join political party. As he joined the political party, he become active member for the party. He can also talk, say, based on the way one or two things they go, if it presents himself to represent the people for inside government for Obodo Nigeria, the thing not go as he take plan. You know, say, man proposes, God disposes. Only God has the final say. But he talk, say, well, the fact say, he there inside, or he not there inside, no me say, go stop the good work when if they do. So he continue. So they see how if he contribute to make Nigeria better. Now, why he don't join us for this discussion this morning? He in a person will be saying, they believe, say, not be about political party. Now, about what do you feel do to move this your country, go the permanent side. And they talk of no other than Oga Honorable Agbeyane Kolawole. Welcome to Coco of the Matter.
Mr. Chukwudi, thank you.
I greet you. Make we not just talk too much. Make we just go straight into our discussion. As Nigeria day like this today now, everybody knows, say, there is fire on the mountain. Anyhow, way you want to see them, with the way where they see kili-kili bonbon for different newspaper, the kind of bad stories where would they hear? It be like, say, the badness don't overshadow the good. No problem there when no get solution. Now, how people won't take suffer, now ain't be the matter. But some people don't come back and talk, say, first and foremost, before we find solution to problem, we must admit, say, na problem. If we not admit, say, na problem, now we say, we not go take the thing serious to find solution to them. Oga Kolawole Egbeyane, make I ask you, especially when believe, say, okay, in finding solution to problem, you must go from point A before you go point B. Conquer the Waka, go point Z. I won't ask you, Shena said the thing we would face for inside of Nigeria, it never reach what some people think say be problem, or those people know they see, say, na problem, now we would face for inside this country.
People will say we will not get problem for this country. That means they know they see. We are in serious war. And this one has even go beyond war. We there for terrorism now. And anybody will say we know there for terrorism at, that means the person know they see. And all over the world, we are not the first person to be in the art of war or terrorism. That means the solution is already there. We support to even solve the problem past the other people that have experienced, because we already see what they did, and we should be able to do better. That's why I keep on saying, people will be giving examples, say, America democracy, take them 200 years. If it took America 200 years, we should even use 2 years to do it, because we already have what to learn from
templates
them. Then we now tailor it. That means it's not rocket science now. If they say it's a new problem, then it's just like we are talking about COVID, because it's a new problem. At the end of the day, look at how within a short time, they get fascination for it. The same thing we are talking about, act of terrorism. It has even gone beyond war, because it's an internal issue. And once it's internal issue, that means it's act of terrorism. And that means there's already a template. Mind you, there's already a research all over the world, which is that there are four ways to combat terrorism.
Four ways to combat terrorism.
Terrorism.
So, no verse, Oga Kolawole, before you can enter inside them, you don't already talk, I mean, say, anybody when talk, say, we know they face problem for this country. Now, if they say, the person not they see. So, I dare very sure, say, everybody for this country go agree, say, we they face serious problem. Make we talk about these four ways to combat terrorism. Before we go enter to who go combat arm, how they go take combat arm, now under umbrella, now under broom, I mean, then go wear glass to look the thing and find the solution. These four ways, what will be these four ways? Fasting and prayer, binding and casting, what will be these four ways?
See, if we in the Bible, when the Israelites were leaving Egypt, when they were crying to God, God told Moses, shut up your mouth. You have something in your hand to use. When God don't give you power to do something, you don't need to go back to God. God has his own part to play. We have our own part to play. God has blessed us with mineral resources in this country. It is our own duty to turn it to wealth. Why do we take it to a foreign country and then not turn it to wealth and bring it back to us? You can see it's no longer in the hand of God. It's in our hand.
True.
Now, this four way to combat terrorism, the number one thing, you must remove the cause, the root cause of terrorism. And the root cause of terrorism are many. Poverty is one of them. Lack of education is one of them. Lack of social amenity is one of them. Entitlement, a citizen see themselves that there are things they are entitled to. Once they are not there, These are root cause of terrorism. Mm. It's a well-defined resource all over the world. That means not new. That means we must tackle poverty. We must tackle education. We must tackle social infrastructure. These are things we must do. These are the root cause of terrorism. Then the next thing, you now begin to look at the capability. Did the country have the capability to do that? And many people now, don't they talk, say, if you don't get the resources, let's look for foreign help. That means if you don't have the capability, then you should not seek help. Who and who can support you? Even your own personal life, when you want to do some things, you look at some areas you don't have opportunity. True. Even we in the accounting profession, when you are going to our year gas to audit, you look for a geologist to work with you. You are not saying you are seeking expert opinion. Then the third aspect is intention. Did the government, the present government, did they have good intention? And they must be sincere about it. And even your intention must not lead you to plan, and that leads you to be specific. Am I going to draw a plan for 5 years or 10 years? And this is what I'm going to do, what I'm going to do. And also in this issue of intention, that means we must begin to reduce the money we spend for buying military equipment. As the year go back, we can set a target for 10 years. Within these 10 years, if we budget $10 billion for security, in the next year, we should reduce it to maybe like $8 billion. The other $2 billion, we use it to tackle the issue of education, we use it to tackle the issue of poverty, we use it to tackle the issue of social security. And then the next thing is talk about defense. And this is also part of that intention. Even if we are still going to keep on defending ourselves so that this terrorism will not have a way, then we must begin to tackle that root cause of terrorism, which is poverty, lack of education, lack of development. Once we do these four things, we'll get solution.
But Oga Kola Wole, the way you take talk this thing, it be like say the thing, they very easy. Not very so. You don't talk, say, now research when they proven. And when people, they talk like people, when they say their school fees no waste. Now essentially waiting the VC. But why they be like, say, our own case, they different? No vex. This is the way you talk now. I agree with you. I sure say people when they ask, when they nod their head, say, yes, we agree with you. In fact, a senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, when they represent Kogi West, Senator Smart Adeyemi, he also agree with you. Make we hear what this Senator Smart Adeyemi talk on the floor of the House of Senate. Before I come bring her back to, okay, if this solution there, why we don't want to do it? Is it because of saying now one party or now another party, or we will look beyond party? Make we not hear the voice of Senator Smart Adeyemi representing Kogi West in cry as it concerns insecurity inside Obodo, Nigeria. Senator Smart Adeyemi, when they represent Kogi West for the House of Senate. Oga Kola Wole, you hear what the Senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria talk? He even sound like person when they say they cry.
Yes.
He even say, if they don't find a solution, make the Kukuma close the National Assembly, make everybody go to their house. And he get one tiny voice when we go hear from the beginning when he starts. When he starts, the person ask him, say, are you PDP? Are you wolf in sheep clothing? That person, that voice, now the voice of Senator Oluremi Tinubu, Lagos Central, APC. Oga Kola Wole, this matter, how we go take VC and beyond say, if you talk like this, you know, go favor my party. If you talk like this, you go favor the opposition. How people when they represent us and those when they government go begin to see this problem as problem when concern all of us and not just about whether you want to embarrass the party or embarrass person when be member of your party?
Until many of other politicians realize that every position you occupy, you are holding in a trust for people. That is just the truth. Once you realize that, that will guard your thought, that will guard your plan, that will guard your action. Like I keep on saying, that is why they talk and say, me, I be proud politicians. One thing I said is a philosophy that even you, before you become a politician, if you are a man, you are either a son to someone, or you are a husband to someone, or you are a father to someone. Then if you are a woman, you are either a daughter to someone, or you are a wife to someone. Then if you are lying, you are lying. There's no way to say this is political lie. No, lie is lie.
Lie na lie.
Either you are a politician, either you are a bishop, either you are a professional, lie is lie. We should get that straight. And we should also know that once you are in a position of authority, you are no longer representing your party. Because the constituency you're representing Both PDPs are there, both APC are there, both people that are not politicians are there. Hmm. And many of these people cast their vote for you. Hmm. Even though you enter there by Magomago, but we still believe that you get their mandate. That means you are representing them, you are not representing APC.
True.
That must be, and that is height of indiscipline. Hmm. That's the height of insincerity. Hmm. If it is a normal clan, that woman should have left that National Assembly that day. Hmm. Either the constituency will have withdraw her, or she will have resigned, or there will be a protest to show that she does not qualify. It doesn't have integrity to maintain that position.
Oga Kola Wole, this talk where we talk, a very, very important one because this matter concerns everybody inside Obodo, Nigeria. What we go do now to just carry Waka enter inside small break. When we go this break, come back. On top of cocoa of the matter, we know they put eye on top of the problem, not solution. The cocoa where they say the matter that say, if we won't find solution to the problem of insecurity, and indeed all the issues we face for this country, not be by whether this person a PDP, or a APC, or a ABGA, or a this party, or a that party. Now about say you be Nigerian, you won't work for the Nigerian people, and you won't find solution to the problem. No go anywhere when they come back. The matter they hurt based on cocoa of the matter. Welcome back to Cocoa of the Matter. My name is Ezugu Chukudi. I'm a Ogbonge visitor now, Honorable Agbeyiane Kola Wole. He don't talk, he say be proud member of political party. Because if you not enter inside, you not go fit do and do when we say, then they do and. But you need to do and well to see, say, you work for the people where you they represent. Now, alone, I make a declare, say, to go that position, no, or to present yourself to vote for election, no, or to, so may they vote for you for election, sorry, may they vote for you for election to exercise your right to suffrage. You must be member of political party. So anybody won't get interest to work for Nigeria and so, or anybody won't get interest to make Nigeria work, oh, supposed to be member of political party. But you don't come out here talk and say, no be by, my party, I don't want to embarrass my party, I don't want to embarrass the president because he's a member of my party. No, he said, now the people where you they represent, now the people where you they work for, and solution day to this particular problem. But Oga Kola, let me ask you. You know, say something went on there, person body for a very long time. It don't turn to practice. It don't be like culture, even though it is bad. But we they get bad aspects of our culture when we they discard. For example, the killing of twin babies for former Eastern Nigeria, for Calabar, when this woman went do plenty work, maybe lesser, do plenty work, go around to see, say they stop. People don't agree, say that isn't a bad thing. Those people, what they do at that time, they feel claim say they don't know. Or they feel claim say that they are understanding at that time. But wait till they bad, they bad. For some people in the political parties, and I know that you too, you don't contest. You remember a political party. Some of your guys and the people when they own a party or the other party, then they always they think, say, make we protect our party first. I won't ask you, before we find a solution to that thing, wait till they cause them. When politicians go look, say, if I talk like this, it will be like, say, I not talk on behalf of my party. Say, now wait till then they see each other. Abi, once they enter political party, they get one thing when they give una. When go make all of una begin, they behave. Not be you, your, as in, whether then they your party or they know they back. What be that thing when they chop? When they make una, they, what be that thing when they chop? When they make them, they behave like that.
You know, when there's no purpose, there's bound to be abuse. Some people enter into policies, they see politics as a meal ticket.
Now their pocket, they think
that
about.
Means there will be an abuse. But if you enter politics, say, I want to serve my people, then you will disregard your party. Your party is just a platform for you to enter. Once you enter, you are representing the people, not your party. Like I said earlier, the constituency you represent, both APC and PDP and non-politicians are there. That means once you get the mandate, you are no longer representing your party. If Nigeria no stand today, can APC stand?
Not at all.
If Nigeria is in crisis today, can PDP stand?
Not at all.
That means the use of party. You are protecting your party. That is a myopic thinking and reasoning. Until you begin to have sincerity or purpose, say whatever affect Nigeria affect us. Some of these people where they talk now because the thing never affect them. Are they busy now? Them get you there where they for that Greenfield University that they've killed. That person no go talk like that
at all.
Because
at all.
They say he never reach you now, make you know.
Exactly.
And some of them thought they safe in the house, they no safe. Even the American president was, you know, assassinated as highly as it is.
Yes.
That means none of them is safe.
So this matter now, the matter will be say, you don't even need to come knock for your door first before you take the thing serious. Now, I like how you first talk about the ways we will deal with terrorism. You don't talk about four ways we will go deal with that. But you get one talk where we say, most people don't need talk. Even Senator Smart, they talk about that. He talks, say, let's call for assistance. Let's call for help. For example, this war against Boko Haram, that's something where we say, if I know they correct with my calculation, 10 years at least. 10 years since that order when Oga Yar'Adua, the late Yar'Adua give, say, deal with this particular situation. 10 years, and we still deal with this problem. So I won't ask you. So people will even start the problem that time, they don't even die. Some don't even forget what the problem be. If like say they don't burn some new people, enter the problem. Look, we look at our population. We get young population. And now from these young people, now in them, they carry people when go come join them. My papa don't pass 70 years old. My papa no go join anybody, carry gun. They do unzobu, unzobu. Now we in children, when still young. Now we, then feel come carry from. What do we need to do to protect this set of people so that these bad people no go fit, they collect from them, they use them anyhow?
No, as I talked earlier, I mentioned four ways.
Yes.
And root cause of tackling the root cause of terrorism is number one.
Hmm.
Because that gives layer to every other thing.
Yes.
And even in that research, the first things that carry number one is poverty.
Yes, you talk.
And with that, the people we're able to recruit.
Yes.
Even me and you, we know say before we get to this level, it's total struggling.
In a struggle. A struggle.
That is, we need to make the environment a lot easy.
Hmm.
Many are struggling, they couldn't come out.
Mm.
That means once we tackle poverty, unemployment, or lack of education, that means we need to make the environment conducive for people to be able to get some minimum thing or some social benefit that can make them be a little comfortable.
Mm.
Because if somebody that is poor, with 1,000 naira, you can win him.
Mm.
And you can also send him a message to go and destroy a place because he knows his hope then you. But if the Nigeria as a nation make the platform easy for people to be able to get some basic thing, let me tell you something. In one of my working experience, there's a guy I work with. He came from this European country. When the company was not organized, things were not working, the guy wrote a nasty email to the group MD, not the MD direct, group MD. I called him, I asked him that, well, how do you have this kind of boldness to write a letter to group MD? And he resigned that same day. He says he's going back to his country. He says, as I'm going back now, there are social benefits I will enjoy and get a job. Me, that is Nigeria, Chukwu, they are not going to try.
At all,
because even as I'm working at the struggle, you know, talk, I don't get a job. The guy resigned that same day. You can see how system works. That means someone like that, as he go back, he doesn't need to worry. His meal is taken care of. His transportation is subsidized. Then he's still called, okay. But when he now want to live more higher life, he will now look for a job. That is what we need to do. If we make education compulsory, we have the resources. Some people carry billion cash, not property, not asset. Billion raw cash that is meant for the 200 million Nigeria, and you are okay with it, and you are sleeping, and you are happy.
Hey.
And yet now, this same effect, you can see this is an accumulative effect. Because poverty have been on ground for long. People have feel marginalized. People have feel humiliated. People believe that things belong to them. Somebody is holding it. And that is why people, they come now, say, okay, let's weaken the security system. That is why they are targeting the security formation now. Let's weaken them. And once we weaken them, we create fear. You can imagine when they create fear in the military formation or system of lawfare in Nigeria. Me and you, can we survive?
Not all.
Once they win the military, create fear in them, weaken them, then they already create fear in the entire Nigeria.
Ogakola Ole Agbehiani, this talk where you don't talk here, you don't finish talk for this particular matter. And I like the fact that you emphasize, say, once we fight poverty, once we invest in education, once we invest in infrastructure, those things where they make people eye, they be like, say, okay, go join bad gang. Go join bad group. Go follow bad people. The thing go come out. Because person will wake up in the morning, he know say, he get family when he they work for. What thing they work for, he they see the gain at the end of the day. He they see family, then they grow.
As he wake up this morning, I will be able to eat my breakfast, eat my lunch,
go to work
dinner.
At the end of the month. Like today will be 20 something now. You don't know say at the end of the month, your salary don't day. Nobody say, you they look, say, hey, how you go pay school fees? How you go do that? How you go do that? All those things that always when we say, we feed them with this problem. So you don't even pastor say, we carry gun. They follow them, they shoot, ki, ka, 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 ka. Oga Kola, I don't be pastor, but I wear tie. I go pray for you. God will continue to give you wisdom.
Amen.
This man, when they used to talk this thing without saying, don't be party, don't be party, God will continue to the strong thing for you. Amen. Our people, when they fast, they talk, say, Nigeria and our country no go spoil. Make we join our hands together to move this our country, go to the permanent site. Until we come back again next week with another cocoa inside the matter, una bye bye. Thank you very much, sir. I'm very-